Hi guys, hope you all are doing good. So guys, the last video which was uploaded by us was related to our apartment tour. So I hope you all would have seen it. So guys, those who haven't seen it, we have given the link in the description below. And also it will be available on the screen somewhere on the top. So guys, after looking at that video, we got many questions from you all asking the difference between what is a condo, what is an apartment, what is the difference between the two, which is better, what is the difference in the rent between the two of them, what all are the facilities available in each one of them, and guys, many such questions like that. So we have taken this particular time to make a video on explaining the differences between what is condo and what is an apartment, what are the differences between the two of them. I hope that our video will help you to make a better informed judgment about which one you should go for, a condo or an apartment, and hopefully we'll be able to help you out with that. So guys, let's get started. So guys, the first differentiating factor between apartment and a condo is ownership. In an apartment, all the units belong to one managed company. So basically all the units are owned, basically the entire building is owned by one managed company. Whereas in case of a condo, each unit is owned by a person, or it can be a company. So basically what happens here is you are dealing directly with one owner of a particular unit. So in case of an apartment, the landlord will be the managed company, and all the units are given on rent to tenants. Whereas in case of a condo, some of the units will be given on rent, while in some of the unit, the owners may themselves stay. Say for example, in this particular unit, so guys, we are staying in a condo apartment. So guys, in this particular condo, we are staying on rent. So we have a landlord who has given this particular unit to us on rent. However, our next door neighbor is the owner of that unit. So in this particular building, there are certain owners who are staying in their own apartment, in their own units, whereas there are certain owners who have given their units on lease to tenants like me. So guys, I hope you understand the difference. In case of apartment, all the units are on rent. In case of condos, some of the units may be available on rent, while in some of the units, the owner may themselves prefer to stay. So guys, the next differentiating factor is the amenities. In case of an apartment, since the landlord is one managed company, that company will not differentiate from one unit to other units. What I mean to say is, the company will choose to have the exact same amenities in all their units. So basically all one bedroom apartment in that particular building will have certain amenities and will have a fixed rent for all the units. Similarly, a two bedroom apartment, irrespective on which floor it is, what is the layout, it will have the exact same features. But if the area changes, like if a two bedroom is of 700 square feet, it may have a different rent. If it is of 800 square feet, it may have a different rent, just because the area is more or less. But guys, the amenities will more or less remain the same. However, in case of a condo, since condo is owned by a person and each person has a different taste, the rent and the amenities may vary. What I mean by this is, say in this particular apartment, our landlord chooses to give us some additional features. He may choose to do so. And say our next door neighbor, who also has the exact same layout, but that landlord does not wish to give some of the features to his tenant. So this may cause a difference in the rent for the exact same area of the unit. So guys, the next differentiating factor is the washer and dryer. In an apartment, the washer and dryer will not be available inside your unit. It will be situated in some common area, which will be accessible to all the tenants of that particular apartment building. Guys, this will be a paid service. So for each use of washer and dryer area, you will have to pay somewhere around $2 to $3 for the washer and $2 to $3 for the dryer. In case of a condo, the washer and dryer will be inside your unit itself, and you need not leave your house to get your clothes washed or anything like that. Now coming to the parking space. Usually in an apartment, there may or may not be a parking space available for you, which means you'll have to pay additionally over and above your rent for the parking space. However, in case of a condo, the landlord usually gives parking space if it is available to you, and you need not pay anything on your rent. However, if you are planning to rent a condo in a building in which the landlord himself does not have a parking space, then in that case you need to get parking space from someone else and you need to pay parking space rent to that particular person. The parking space may range anywhere between $60 to $120 depending on whether it's underground, overground, covered or uncovered parking. So guys, the next differentiating factor is issue resolution and maintenance requests. Say for example, if you are in an apartment and your unit needs some kind of maintenance or you are having some issues in your unit, most complexes will have a web portal or they may have a person dedicated in the office who would be available to take your requests, and then the managed company will try to resolve it in a timely manner. However, in case of a condo apartment, and if you need to raise some kind of issues or maintenance requests, it will go to your landlord who may not be there available immediately as per your convenience. So guys, in case of an apartment, you can expect timely resolution of your issues. However, there may be some delays in case of a condo apartment. So guys, renting an apartment offers more professional services. However, renting a condo has a personal touch. So in a condo, you have a more direct relationship with your landlord, and you can have that rapport with your landlord, so that you have a cordial stay when you are renting a condo. So guys, in my words, I would say that renting an apartment is like one size fits all. So there are like hundreds of units. Each unit will have the exact same amenity. Whether you like it or you don't like it, they will not change it for you, because they have like a fixed structure, and whatever they have, you have to take that if you want to stay there. However, in case of a condo, the relationship is more mutual. So say for example, I'll give you my own personal example. So in this particular unit, there was no microwave available in the unit. However, I had requested my landlord to give me an additional microwave. So my landlord basically agreed to it. So this basically creates a sense of harmony between you and your landlord, because that is like more mutual, like it's more or less like a friendship rather than a professional relationship. However, in case of an apartment, if you request for something which is not given to any of the unit, they might not even give it to you. So guys, you are getting the point. So there is like more personal touch in case of a condo, which is not available in an apartment. So guys, one more important differentiating factor is the age of the building. Guys, in most of the cases, apartments are older buildings. So there are some apartments which are new construction also. But if suppose there is a building which was constructed many years ago, it is very difficult for them to upgrade all their units at once now. Whereas in case of a condo, it is easier for the landlord to upgrade his unit before giving it on rent. So guys, in an apartment, there are people who are always on rent, and there is a waiting list of people who are willing to take a particular unit on rent. So apartments have very restricted time to do upgrades in all the units. However, it is comparatively very easier to upgrade a single condo unit. So guys, personally, I feel that renting an apartment is slightly cheaper, but condos are comparatively expensive. But in case of an apartment, you have additional costs, like you need to pay for your washer, dryer, sometimes the parking may not be available, and all those things. So guys, say if you are looking at a city A, and inside that city A, in a particular neighborhood, there is one apartment and one condo which is available. The price of apartment would be slightly less as compared to a condo, but considering all the costs involved, the additional overhead costs, the difference is not that much. So this is my personal opinion. If you guys feel otherwise, please let us know in the comment section below. So guys, as a new immigrant, I tried to get into an apartment first, but since I did not have a job at that point in time, I didn't have a credit history in Canada, I didn't have any background in Canada, my application got rejected from multiple apartments. So even though I was assuring them to pay rent in advance for a couple of months, but still they were very rigid. But I found that condo owners are more flexible. So when I got this particular apartment, my landlord did not insist me on procuring documents and proof of credibility or something like that. I just gave 1 month rent and 1 month security deposit, and that's it. So personally speaking, I find apartment is more rigid because the managed company has to follow the rules, which is same for one and all, no exceptions. However, in case of a condo, there is a lot of flexibility as you are building a direct trust and a direct rapport with your landlord. So guys, that's my own personal choice. So guys, as I already mentioned earlier, that in an apartment, the management is taken care of by a company. However, in condos, the management is taken care of by a group which is known as Homeowners Association. So in case of an apartment, you are dealing with a company. In case of a condo, you are dealing with your landlord, who is a part of the Homeowners Association group. So guys, whenever you are thinking of renting an apartment, the apartment managed company will usually check for your credit history, your background history in Canada, your job security and things like that. Whereas in case of a condo, you have a direct relationship with your landlord. So in this case, there is a possibility that your landlord may not go insist on all these checks, and he may straight away give you the apartment on rent. So there is like more trust involved in case of a condo. This is my personal experience, so I am telling you this. So this I could not find in an apartment. So guys, both apartment and condo have their own advantages and disadvantages. Please let us know in the comment section below, what would you prefer if you were given a chance, a condo or an apartment? So guys, now if you ask me what I would prefer, my answer would be that I will settle for a condo. That's my own personal thinking. So please let us know if you think otherwise in the comment section. So guys, that's it for the day. I hope you like the contents of this video, and I really hope that our points of differentiating between condo and an apartment will help you to find a suitable home for you. So guys, enjoy and have a great day. Goodbye.